Hi, Will Crockett here. Welcome to Shoot Smarter University, where all of our video content is now view on demand online for $9.99, every one of the titles, $9.99 each. Get you 90 days to be able to watch this video on any screen that you want to. This video is one that we made with Friday Photo School's production team, and it is one of the best lighting videos we've ever made.
I think I'm going to turn this sideways so I have a little bit more up and down light. Would you turn your body towards the light a little bit, Isabella? Okay. And I'd like you to just tilt your head just a touch. I like that little head tilt because it adds a little curve in the picture. It's very nice on flow, helps your composition, and just a lovely little smile. Close your lips just a little bit of a grin. Lovely. Say hi. Hi. Chin up a touch. Beautiful. There we go. Okay. So for this photo, you can see now, we've got still have dimension. You see, we've got shadow on the side. We've got a little shadow around the nose.
And let's see what we got.
Okay, that's F5, and I'm on 5.6. Normally, I go for that one stop less. But again, this isn't everything depends. So I'm going to take a look at it and see what I think. Main light is still 5.6. That hasn't changed. I want you to just kind of like do this. Okay, actually, this is a really pretty shot. The way that we have this set up, that's really lovely. I got to get centered. There we go. Say hi.
Hi.
Beautiful. Okay, you know what? It's a little too spotlighty. So as you can see right here, I've got it too close to the background, but it's looking pretty nice. But I'm going to spread it out a little bit more.
Wants to know, why are you shooting with your lens wide open at F4?
The reason that I decided to shoot at F4 is because I'm using a background. It's not a plain paper background. It's a muslin background. So it's got some modeling to it, some tonality that shifts around. I don't want that to be in sharp focus. I want it to be a little bit more out of focus. So when I use that selective depth of field, that less depth of field, then I'm creating that illusion of it going further away from me. They're just too dark. So I want to fill it in. This reflector has a white side and a gold side. The way that you use the reflector is to catch the main light and bounce it back in. Wow. Look at the difference. See how much that bounces light in? We control it just by moving it in closer or taking it further away. The further away it is, the softer the shadows, the darker the shadows, and it's a little moodier. If you have a hard time seeing it, take out the reflector, put it back in again. Meter reading. When I take readings, what I do is with the incident bulb, I try to get the light falling on the bulb the same way that the light falls on the face. This is part about being aware. You know, you've got to make sure that you can see what the light is doing. So when I have the face half lit, I want to have the bulb half lit. Or drop that shoulder down a little bit more if you can. That's it. Oh, that's it. That's it. That's the beautiful lean right there. Gorgeous. Gorgeous. There it is. That's what I want. You see when I drop that shoulder, how it just kind of opened up a little bit, but I'm really sculpting that face. Super, super dramatic. I love to use hair lights with a strip light. Okay? Dun, da, da, da. I feel like now I'm Vanna White. I've taken over Will's job. So a strip light is half the size of the normal softbox, as you can see. And we have the grid on this as well because I don't want it to spread out. And remember, people are going to look at this picture for a long time. It's got to have meaning. It's got to have the depth that you want. It's got to have that feeling. And it's not that hard to do. It's all about you becoming visually aware, visually acute, and really paying attention to the detail. Oh, beautiful. Look how beautiful that is. Look at what happens when you add that hair light now. We've given a completely different kind of dimension to this picture than we had before. The light on her face looks great. That hair light looks absolutely beautiful. You know what? That's a keeper. You can take your speed light and mount it into this softbox. There's all kinds of handy dandy little things. And look what I happen to have right here. Okay, you see this? This right here is the speed ring. So the softbox is going to attach to this. And if you can see this right here, this is where your speed light will go. It just slides right in here into this. It's a hot shoe attachment. You screw it down, and then it is pointed directly through here into the softbox. Turn that just a touch. Okay, so this is going to be a little bit more dramatic. I actually would kind of like you to turn your face this way a touch. There you go. Oh, yeah, that's really cool. That is cool. Okay, let's see what that looks like. Oh, cool. Oh, that's so cool. All right, I got to do another one. I'm going to change it just a little bit. I kind of like that. I like that with it hanging down like that. That's beautiful. Beautiful. Okay, now with this, ooh, look at that. What happens here is that this is one of my favorite things to do. If you look on camera left, the background is dark. On camera right, the background has tonality to it.
This product is Crockett approved.